Guys, welcome to another video from the guy without a plan. The place I'm going to today is a heaven for people who like wine and also has a type of wine named after it. So here I am in the capital of wine in the city called Bordeaux. Waiting eagerly to see whatever the city has to offer, Mouad Alcool. So let's roll the intro. Today I am starting my city stroll from a place called Place de la Bourse, which literally translates into the place of the purse. This majestic square was built on the bank of Garonne River in 1720s. Louis XV's favorite architect, Jacques Gabriel, designed it, and the square didn't take long to become a symbol for the city. Going closer, we see mascarons or sculpted faces beneath the arches of the building. And just across this place is the water mirror created by landscape artist Michel Courajou. Now if you guys are wondering where is the water mirror I'm talking about, so the problem is it's not summer and it happens to be a very cold day. So these people have stopped the mist and therefore since there's no water, there's no reflection. So I am sorry for that. That's what I hear when you're by my side. Now moving ahead, here I am at my next stop, which is Quai de Bordeaux, which happens to be on the left bank of the Garonne River. Now this is part of the 18th century World Heritage Ensemble, where the majestic facades of grand neoclassical buildings line the riverside promenade 80 meters wide. It is set next to the broad Garonne River, crossed by many arches of Pont des Pierres. One also finds sweeping openness for walking and cycling. Don't let this be our final song. Spanning almost 600 meters and reaching up to 77 meters in height, the bridge that you see behind me is the tallest lift bridge in Europe. And it's called Pont Jacques Chaban de Mâts. Now there is a possibility to go up, but and you can use either a lift or the stairs. But again, it is closed due to COVID. And I would suggest if you want to see this bridge, then definitely take a walk on this Quai de Bordeaux during the night and you'll see the lighting, so it will look much better. Now this ultra modern cultural center which you see behind me is the celebration of everything wine and everything that is related to Bordeaux. So just to celebrate their wine heritage, they recently in 2016 they have built this Cité du Vin. If you are coming here, I would say that along with seeing the architecture of the old Bordeaux, you should definitely come and spend some time here. It will take you, I think, around a day to fully see this place, experience the wine tasting and everything. But this place is something that you should definitely visit if you are coming to Bordeaux. So this is a high-tech museum which teaches you about the history of wine, where and how it's made around the world. So there is 10 hours worth of audiovisual material to get through. But if you are into wine, then I would say this is a place you should not miss. This be our final song. So right now I'm standing in a 12 hectare spacious area that houses the monument of Gironda, with a column topped with Statue of Liberty and fountains with ramping bronze horses at the foot. It was designed to recognize the role of Gironde political group in the French Revolution. Alright guys, so I was walking around and I came across another Notre Dame. Don't let this be our final song. So let's check it out from inside. So this square where I'm standing right now, it is the center of Bordeaux, and there are three attractions here which you should definitely visit. The first one is the City Hall. The second is the Bellon Tower, which as you guys saw was closed. And the third is the Bordeaux Cathedral, which is right behind me. Let's check out this cathedral from inside since it's open. The site where in 1137 Eleanor of Aquitaine and future Louis VII wed at just 13 and 17 respectively. Alright, so this cathedral was pretty big, and it's even bigger than the one I went to in Montpellier. Rue Saint Catherine is the longest pedestrian shopping street in Europe, and as you can see, COVID hasn't changed the crowd here that much. Now this place where I'm standing right now is called Place de la Victoire, and it is alongside this a gate which is from 1700. Alongside the city gate from 1700, it's a peculiar piece of modern public art designed by the France-based Czech sculptor Ivan Thémier. The work is made with marble blocks, forming a column 16 meter tall. It was installed in 2005, and despite city's long winemaking heritage, It was the first monument ever built to recognize viticulture in Bordeaux. Now with that, it's time to head to the last stop for today, which is the old Big Bell of Bordeaux. Built in the 15th century, La Grosse Cloche, with its twin conical roof, is the old belfry of Bordeaux town hall. It is one of only a handful of fragments remaining from the city's medieval period. This gate once used to have a small prison for juvenile offenders, and they were kept behind the door 10 centimeters thick. The bell weighs a hefty 7,750 tons, and this bell only rings on public holidays and celebrations like Bastille Day. But I'm sure if it was in India, then it would definitely ring on our PM's birthday. So that's all for today, guys. Before you go, do not forget to click the like button and subscribe to the channel so that you do not miss the next destination where I am heading to. And if you like the behind the scene footage, then stay till the end. Water I've seen, and generally you find blue water, blue seas, and this one is like very muddy. It was muddy in the previous year, you have recognized it was greenish, now just turned into brown, very